Good day, everyone. Welcome to lecture number 11 of Theory of Computation. And in this particular lecture, we will continue the discussion about non-deterministic finite automata. We will also discuss what is epsilon transition and what are epsilon energies. Then, at the end, we will discuss power state construction or subset. So let me first recap what we have already discussed in lecture number 10 about the NFAs. So NFA, which is also called a non-deterministic finite automata.
Oops, battery low.
So in non-deterministic finite automata, we know that what are the features of this NFA? So, at every state, there are 0, 1 or more transitions possible.
Oops, battery low.
This is the one feature of an NFA. Second, we have discussed that you can see that in the first point, we are saying that at every state, there is some choice, okay? Some choice on the alphabet, input alphabet. And we say that NFA accepts a string.
Battery low.
String. If at least one of the choices leads to a final state. So this thing we have already discussed in lecture number 10, or we can say in the stack notation definition, we are doing L is equal to L means language of an NFA, or the strings that this NFA accepts. The language of an NFA include the string such that delta Q0, where Q0 is the initial state of NFA, W is equal to F dash, such that F dash intersection F is not equal to 5.
Oops, battery low.
So F dash means the set of states where we can reach from Q0, the possible set of states. And if at least one of these states is the final state, okay, that means this string will be accepted. Fine. So now let's make an NFA. Let's make a simple NFA. For example, here, let's say this is our NFA. So let me use a different pen.
Battery low.
So let's say this is our NFA. So alphabet is A comma B, and let me make the transition. Let's say this one is the final state. And let's make the transition now. This is Q.
This Q1. Okay. And this is Q2, this is our final state. Fine. So these are the three states, Q0, Q1, and Q2. Let's make a finite automata. Okay. So this is our NFA, non-deterministic finite automata. Fine. And if you can see that in this finite automata, in this NFA, what is the language? You can see that language, if you can, you will try it out. So it includes all those strings such that W ends with AE. It will accept only those strings. those strings where the string ends with A. And we know that in our DFA, so this is the language of this finite automata. In our DFA, we said a DFA can be represented formally. So one was the formal definition. The second was that we can represent DFA using a state diagram. Okay. And the third method, we said that we can represent a DFA using a transition table. Okay. These are the three methods by which we can represent a DFA. Likewise, for NFA, there are three different methods by which we can define it. First is we can define NFA formally. Formally, what we use to define, that means we have to define Q, we have to define start, we have to define this alphabet set, we have to define a transition function, and we have to define the set of final states. Okay. So one is formally, second is using a state diagram. And the third, so second, we have already represented here. This is our second representation, this. So this is the state diagram. Fine. And the third method is using a transition table. So we can represent, like DFAs, we can represent NFA as well using these three different methodologies. So we know how to represent formally. We know this. We know state diagram also. Let's see how we can define it using a transition table. So how we are defining, we can say an NFA using a transition table. So the similar way, the way we were discussing the DFA, transition table for DFA, we can make it similarly for NFAs as well. So from this side, we have the input. And from this side, we have the state. Okay. So this is for an NFA. Transition table for an NFA. So let's, what is the input? Input is A and B. Okay. And what is the output? Sorry, input is A and B. What is the state? We always start with the initial state, that is Q0. Okay, like we used to do in the DFA. Fine. So on Q0, we will check where we will reach on when we see this particular symbol, this A. So on Q0, if A comes, so this is Q0 here. So on Q0, if A comes, what are the possible outputs? The possible output is either it will remain in Q0. So there are two transitions possible on A. So one is it will stay in Q0 and another is it will go to Q1. So these are the two possible states. Okay. On seeing which alphabet, on seeing which symbol, A symbol. So these are the two possible states. One choice is Q0 and another choice is Q1. Okay. Now, on this Q0, if B comes, so if B comes, it will remain in this particular state on Q0. So let's write every state in this set definition. Why in set definition? Because in our NFAs, the output of a transition function will always be a set. It cannot be a single state. It is a single state in case of a DFA, but in case of an NFA, the output of a transition function is the set of all possible states that we can reach from one particular state. Fine. So on Q0, if A comes, we can go to Q0 and Q1. If B comes, we will remain in Q0. So let's represent this state as well in terms of set definition. Okay. So which one is the new possible state? So this is the new possible. Which one? Q0, Q1. So on Q0, Q1.
So this is our Q0 and Q1. Now we have to check what will be on Q0 if A comes. So if A comes, what will be the output? Output can be Q0 and Q1. Okay. Now on Q1, if A comes, what will be the output? The output will be Q2. So that means in this particular state, so Q0, Q1 state. So basically it is not a state, but this is how we represent it in a transition table. So in Q0, Q1, if A comes, what are the possible outputs? The possible outputs are Q0, Q1 and Q2. Okay. And now if on these two states, Q0, Q1, if B comes, what will happen? Okay, so on Q0, if B comes, it will remain in Q0. And on Q1, if B comes, so on Q1, there is no transition defined on B. So that means not defined. Not defined means it won't go anywhere. So what will be the final? Final will be Q0. It will be union of these two. Okay, so here union of these two was Q0, Q1, Q2. Here union of these two, Q0 and not defined is Q0. So that means on B, it will go to Q0. Okay. So this one is complete. Now we have this. So which one is the new state? So this one has been completed. This one has also been completed. So this one and this one. Now new is this one. So which one it is? It is Q0, Q1, Q2. So let's see what will happen. Okay. On Q0, this Q0, if A comes, what is the output? Q0, Q1. Okay. On Q1, if A comes, what is the output? It is Q2. Now on Q2, if A comes, it is not defined. So what will be the output? The output will be the union of these three. The output will be Q0, Q1, Q2. And if B comes, what will be the output? So on Q0, if B comes, it will remain in Q0. On Q1, if B comes, it is not defined. And on Q2, if B comes, it is also not defined. So what will be the output? The output will be Q0. Now, this one has been completed, this one completed, this one also completed, this also completed, this also completed, this one here in this step. Okay. Here we have completed, this also completed. Is there any new state? No. We always start from the initial state. Then whenever some new comes in the transition table, we have to check for that new as well. So this is the transition table representing this particular finite automata, or we can say representing this particular NFA. Fine. So this is how we represent NFA for NFA using a transition table. Okay. And this also completes our discussion regarding the non-deterministic finite automata. Okay. Now comes one spatial automata or a type of NFA, that is epsilon NFA. So now let's discuss what is an epsilon NFA. So let me rub this portion here and then we will start what is epsilon NFA. So before discussing this epsilon NFA, let's discuss about epsilon transition. What is an epsilon transition? So what is a transition? Transition means that going from one state to another, upon consuming an input symbol. So we have an input symbol, and on that input symbol, we go from one state to another state, and that is defined by a transition. Okay. And now what is an epsilon transition? Epsilon transition means going from one state to another, going from one state to another without consuming an input symbol. So if we are going from one state to another state without consuming an input symbol, that particular transition will be an epsilon transition. So let's say this is my state. This is state Q0 and this is state Q1. Now, if I have a transition from Q1 to Q2, and on top of that, we have epsilon. Epsilon means that without consuming, we can go from Q0 to Q1. Okay. So let me make a simple NFA here. So let's say this is NFA. Let's see. A, and it is for alphabet. Okay. So now let's say I have this particular string. Now let's see how this particular NFA consumes this particular symbol, this particular string. So first we are in start state. What is start state? Q0. Okay. So Q0. So initially we are at Q0. Now A comes, okay, on Q0 A comes, where can it go? On A, is there any transition defined? No, there is no transition defined. So it will say not defined. Okay. However, before consuming A, it is possible that we have moved from Q0 to Q1, because it is possible to move from Q0 to Q1 without consuming any symbol. So it is possible that initially we were in Q0 and we moved to Q1 without consuming anything. Why? How it is possible? It is possible because there is epsilon transition from Q0 to Q1. So it is possible that we have moved from Q0 to Q1 and then we consumed A. So then we consumed A means now we are in Q1 and we have consumed A. Where we will go? We will go to state Q0. So in this particular NFA, if we are in state Q0 and if symbol, this symbol, if symbol A comes, so this is transition here. Let me rub it and write it clearly. So on Q0, now let's suppose A comes, what will be the output? One possible output is that it will consume this A. Q0 will consume this A. Okay. After and consuming this A means it won't go anywhere because there is no transition defined on A. The other possibility is, this is one possibility. Second possibility is Q0 first moved from Q0 to Q1 using this epsilon transition. After moving to Q1, it has consumed this A, this particular A. So consumed this A means on Q1, we are in Q1. Now A comes. A comes means we will go to Q0. So second possibility is Q0. So what will be the output? Output will be union of these possibilities. And union of these possibilities, Q0. Okay. So on A, it has moved to where? Q0. On another A, now what is the possibility? Where it is? It is in Q0. Another A comes, so it will again be in Q0. Okay. Another A comes, it will remain in Q0. If we check, after consuming these three, the final state is this Q0. Or we can say the final state in which it will be in, it will be Q0. So will this particular NFA accept this particular string? No. Why? Because after consuming these three, it reaches to this state, or we can say it has multiple choices possible, and it has, and in those possible, in those choices, no one reaches to a final state. Okay. So this particular automata does not accept this particular string. So can this automata accept this particular string? BB. This particular automata. So let's say alphabet is A comma B. let's see whether it will accept this B or B. So initially we are in Q0. Okay, in Q0, B comes. Now B comes, one possibility is not defined. Means on Q0, we have nothing defined. Okay, another possibility is it has Q0 has first consumed this epsilon. Epsilon means it has itself moved to Q1. Okay, it has itself moved to Q1. Now on Q1, B comes. Now on Q1, which comes? B comes. Is there any transition defined on Q1? On B? No, it will show not defined. So this is also not defined. So on this first B. Now second B comes. In second B, there are two possibilities. This not defined and this not defined. That will again reach to not defined. Okay, so that means will this automata accept this particular string? No, neither it will accept this nor it will accept this. So which type of string will it accept? If you can see, it can only accept epsilon string. Epsilon means it can only accept empty string. Okay, so this particular automata, so we have only shown a simple automata here. I will show some complex ones. So this particular automata, this one, in which there are epsilon transitions. Epsilon transition means a transition without consuming an input. And these NFAs are called epsilon non-deterministic finite automata. So what is an epsilon non-deterministic finite automata? It is an NFA with an epsilon transition. And what is an epsilon transition? And epsilon transition means going from one state to another state without consuming an input symbol. Okay, so this is the epsilon NFA. Now let's see an example of an NFA that will help us to clear out the misconceptions that we may have here. Okay, so let me give one example, but before that I will wrap this section. So let me design an NFA here, one of the NFA. Okay, let's see, sigma is 0, 1, fine, and let's name these states. This is Q0, Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4, Q5, Q6, okay, and this is, let's suppose, epsilon transition. This is also an epsilon transition. This is 0 and 1. This is 1 and 1. Fine. So let me write a simple definition of this epsilon NFA. So what type of language or what type of strings this particular NFA or epsilon NFA will accept? It will accept W belonging to sigma star such that W ends with 0, 1 or 1, 1. W ends with 0, 1 or 1, 1. Or let me simplify this a little bit. So let's remove some of the transitions so I can write it like this. So let me make these arrows here to depict a transition. So this is one, okay. And the language, you can see that this is an NFA. And what type of NFA? It is an epsilon NFA. Why epsilon NFA? Because there are epsilon transitions. Now on this NFA, let's give some strings. The first string is, let's see, will it accept this particular string? 10010, or it is a long string, let's make it short, 100. Let's see whether it will accept this. Let's make a flow of die figures. So initially it is in Q0, okay? Now which symbol comes? One comes. So on this Q0, one comes. This one, first one, okay? On Q0, one comes. So one possibility is that it will consume this one, okay? On this one, there is no transition definer. So it will go to not defined. Okay. However, another possibility is that this Q0 will first move to Q1 because there is epsilon transition possible from Q0 to Q1, and then it will consume one. Okay. So from Q0 to Q1, so it will first go from Q0 to Q1 by consuming epsilon. Epsilon means it has not consumed anything. Now on Q1, it will consume one, this particular one. Okay. And what will be the output? The output will be not defined. Okay. So the second possibility is also not defined. What is the third possibility? The third possibility is Q0 will move to Q4 by consuming epsilon. So Q0 will move to Q4. By consuming which alphabet, which symbol? Epsilon. But epsilon means I have not consumed anything. Then it will consume one. Then it will consume one. So on Q4, on one, we will go to Q5. So output, another possibility is Q5. Okay. So if I am on Q0 and now one comes, so what are the possibilities? The possibilities are three: not defined, non-defined, and Q5. That means the union of these three. The union of these three will be Q5. Okay. So one has completed. Now what is the other one? The other one is zero. Now zero comes. Zero comes means now there are three possibilities. So not defined means this path cancels. This path is also out. Now we are in Q5, this particular state, Q5. Q5, on Q5, which symbol is coming? Zero. So on zero, is there any transition defined? So it is not defined. Okay. So on Q5, if zero comes, it is not defined. Okay. So zero is completed. One is completed, zero is completed. Now another zero. Another zero means there is no possible transition from this not defined. Okay, so that means on 100, if we have 100, we are going to which paths? Not defined path, not defined path, not defined path. Is there any path that leads to a final state? No, a big no. So that means this string is not accepted by this particular automata. Now let's take another string. Let's take 101. Okay, so on 101, let's see. Let's make a transition table also. So this is initial state. Sorry, this is 0 and 1. Okay. Initially, we are in Q0. So that means initially we are in Q0. Now 1 comes. Okay. So on Q0, 1 comes. One possibility is not defined. Okay. 1 is input. Another possibility is, because in Q0 on 1, we don't have any transition. Another possibility is Q0 has moved to Q1. So Q0 has moved to Q1 by consuming epsilon. Okay. Then on Q1, it will consume 1. Consuming 1 means not defined. Why not defined? Because on Q1, we have no path defined. So other possibility is not defined. The third is, what is the third possibility? Third possibility is Q0 has moved to Q4. Q0 has moved to Q4 by consuming epsilon. Okay. And then on Q4, we have 1. So on Q4, on 1, we will go to Q5. So the third possibility is Q5. So that means if we are in Q0 and 1 comes, So if we are in Q0 and one comes, this one comes, what will be the output? The output is union of these three. So the output will be Q5. So that means if I have consumed one, what is the output? Output is Q5. This is the possible choice. Now we have to check on Q5. On Q5, if second symbol comes, zero comes. So we have now Q5. Now if zero comes, on Q5, zero comes, what is the possibility? On Q5, one possibility is okay. So on Q5, if you can check on Q5, one possible, please let me rewrite this. So the language of this automata, I make a small mistake here, is strings such that W is either 0, 1 or 1, 1. Okay. So it will accept only these two strings, 0, 1 and 1, 1 string. Okay. So this string, it should not be accepted. So let's see on Q5, if 0 comes, what is the output? Output is not defined. So is there any other possible choice? No. So if 0 comes, output is not defined. So not defined means now 1 has completed, 0 has completed. We have this one now. This one now, and in which state we are? We are in not defined state. Not defined means we won't go anywhere else. So that means this string won't be accepted because it reaches to a not defined state. Okay. Now let's check by yourself against this string. 1, 1. Okay. You will see that finally we will reach to a final state. You will check final state. On 1, 1, we will reach to a final state. So what I wanted you to understand in this particular slide, or we can say in this particular discussion, is that in our epsilon NFAs, like NFAs, we have multiple choices possible. And if any of this choice leads to a final state, that means that particular string will be accepted. However, if we didn't reach to a final state, that means that that particular string won't be accepted. Okay. And as I have shown you here, that for every transition in an NFA or epsilon NFA, the output is the set of states. And if any of these states, these particular states, is a final state, then this particular string will be accepted. Okay, this W will be accepted. Fine. Let me summarize this NFA and NFA again, then we can move to further discussion. Okay, let me rub this and we will summarize it. Then we will get a greater, we can say, understanding. Then we will discuss what is this power set or subset construction. So we said that we were discussing about the NFA, or we can say an absolute NFA. Okay. And on this NFA, if we have to check a string, on any string, or we can say W. Okay. What we do, we take the extended transition function from the initial state to W. Okay. And what will be the output? The output will be the set of states. What does that mean? Let me give an example here. So again, the similar example, the example that we were discussing in our previous slide. But I will change it a little bit. A simple change I will put forward here. So this is Q0, Q1, Q2, Q3, and Q4, Q5. Okay. This is epsilon, this is epsilon, this is 0, 1, this is 1, 1. And let's add another one here, that is 0, 1. Okay. So this is our NFA, one of the NFA. Let me write the language for this NFA. The language is W belongs to 0, 1 star, such that W ends with 0, 1 or 1, 1. Okay. So this means it will accept those strings which end with 0, 1 or 1, 1. So let's first check for this string. So let's take two strings, two or three strings. Let's check for 1, 1, 0, 1. And let's check for 0, this particular. And let's check for this one. 0, 1, 1. So these two should be accepted, this should be rejected, and this should be accepted. Let's see. So let's see what will happen if we start from Q0 and use the first string. What is string? 1, 1, 0, 1. Let's see what will be the output. Okay. So this means that on Q0, first we have to check for this one, then the next one, then 0, then 1. So let's first check for, so let me write it here. Let's first check for Q0 on 1. What will be the output? Q0 on 1. Let's check the first one. Okay. So if we are in Q0, now 1 comes. So if on Q0, 1 comes, what are the possibilities? One possibility is we will consume this 1 and we will remain in Q0. Because one possibility is we will remain in Q0. Another possibility is that Q0 will first consume epsilon. Okay. And it will mute to Q1. This side. This particular side. And it will mute to Q1. Now on Q1, it will consume 1. So on Q1 consuming 1, the output is not defined. Okay. Another possibility is that it will follow this path. It will first consume this epsilon. Okay. So Q0 will consume epsilon. And it will go to Q4. And on Q4, it will consume 1. So on Q4, if 1 comes, what will be the output? Q5. So that means on Q0, there are three possibilities. This, this, and this. So what will be the output? The output may be either Q0 or not defined. So let's not write not defined or Q5. So these are the two choices. One is it will remain in Q0 and another choice is it will remain in Q5. So that means on Q0, when we are doing this, when we are consuming 1, what is the output? The output is Q0 and Q5. So we are either in, there are two choices. We may be in Q0 or we may be in Q5. Now, after this particular one, we have the second one. We have to check whether we will be in second one by consuming second one. So by consuming first one, where are we? We are either in Q0 or in Q5. Okay. Now we have to check for second one. We have to check for second one, both for Q0 and for Q5. Now for Q0, what is the possibility? We have already checked for possibility for Q0. So Q0, the possibility for second one is again Q0 and Q5. And for Q5, because we have to check for Q5 also. Okay. If we are in Q5 and 1 comes, what is the possibility? The possibility is we will go to Q3. So that means when we are consuming the second one, okay, where can we be? We can be in Q0, Q5 or Q3. So these are the three possibilities. We are in Q0, Q5 or Q3. This is the second possibility. So this is delta Q0, Q5. So if we are in Q0, Q5 and 1 comes, then this is the possibility. We may be in Q0, Q5 or Q3. So second one is also completed. Now comes the third one. So that means currently, after consuming these two, first two ones, first one and second one, where are we? We are in this state, Q0, Q0, Q5, Q3. So these are the three possible states, Q0, Q5, Q3. Now, which one comes? Zero comes. Now, what will be the output? So we have to check for Q0, for Q5 and Q3, for zero. First, let's check for Q0. So on Q0, if zero comes, what is the output? What are the possibilities? If you can check, there are again three possibilities. One is we may be in Q0. Okay. We may be in Q2. So you check it out yourself, and another will be not defined. So let's write these two only. So Q0 is done. Now Q5. So if we are in Q5 and zero comes, what is the output? Not defined. If we are in Q3, so Q3. If we are in Q3 and zero comes, what is the output? The output is not defined. Okay. So that means when we have zero, these are the three possibilities. So what will be the output? Union of these three. So the output is Q0, Q2. So that means when we have consumed this zero, where can we be in? We can be in Q0 on this state, in Q0 state, or in Q2, or in Q2. Now three are completed, one completed, another one, and zero complete. Now we have the last one. So in which states we are in? We may be in Q0 or Q2. Now in Q0 or Q2, one comes, what will happen? So you can check. First, we have to check for Q0. So for Q0, we have already checked. If one comes, what will be the output? Q0, Q5. Now on Q2. On Q2, if one comes, what is the output? Q3. So it will be union of these three. So what is the union of these three? Q0, Q5, Q3. So is there any other symbol now? No. All symbols have been consumed. So what is the output? So this means that on Q0, in this NFA, on Q0, if this string comes, we will be in either in Q0. So there are three choices. We may be in Q0 or in Q5 or in Q3. So that means there are three paths. One path leads us to Q0, another path leads us to Q5, and another path leads us to Q3. And we have already said that if any path leads to final state, what does that mean? If any path leads to a final state, that means this particular string will be accepted. Since there is one state that is a final state, so that means there is one path that leads to a final state. Okay, so that means this particular string will be accepted. This string will be accepted. Now you have to check same for second string and third string, and check whether these two strings, which string leads to a final state and which strings leads to a non-final state. Fine. So that means that when we have an epsilon NFA or an NFA, we have to check for all the possibilities. And if any possibility leads to a final state, that means that particular string will be accepted. And if there is no state that leads to a final, there is no path that leads to a final state, that means that particular string won't be accepted. And in epsilon NFA, you have to remember one thing. In epsilon NFA, whenever you have to find a transition on some state with some symbol, what will be the output? How you will check the output? What you have to do? You have to first find epsilon closure of that particular state. What is the meaning of epsilon closure? Epsilon closure means all states that can be reached by consuming epsilon. by consuming epsilon minus by consuming nothing. Okay, because epsilon minus nothing. Okay, so let's take an example. What will be the epsilon closure of Q0 in the above example? In this example, epsilon closure of Q0. Epsilon closure of Q0 minus all states that can be reached from Q0 by consuming nothing. So what are the all states? First is Q0 itself, because Q0 will be in the epsilon closure of itself. Why? Because I am in Q0 and without consuming anything, I will remain in Q0. Okay, so Q0 is first. State itself is always in its epsilon closure. You have to remember this. Second, so another possibility is it will go from Q0 to Q1 using epsilon. So the second state is Q1. The other possible state is Q4. Is there any other possible state? No. Okay. So this is the epsilon closure of Q0. Now let's find out epsilon closure of Q1. What will be the epsilon closure of Q1? So Q1 itself is always. So is there any other path without consuming any symbol I can reach? No. So only Q1. Likewise, epsilon closure of Q4 is Q4. Epsilon closure of Q5 is Q5. Okay. Now, whenever I have to find a transition on a state on some symbol, first job that I have to do is to find epsilon closure of that state. And after finding the epsilon closure, I have to then find what will be the output in these states by consuming this symbol. What does that mean? For example, so I will rub some portion from here. Okay. So let me rub it first. So let's say you have to find what will be the output if I am in Q0 and zero comes. What will be the output? Okay. What you have to do, you have to first find epsilon closure of Q0. What is the epsilon closure of Q0? It is Q0, Q1, Q4. Okay. Then you have to find that on all these states, what will be the output if zero comes? So on Q0, okay. So on Q0, if zero comes, what is the output? Not defined. So on Q1, if zero comes, what is the output? Q2. So on Q4, if zero comes, what is the output? Not defined. Okay. So this you have to do. Then you have to find epsilon closure of these outputs. So epsilon closure of not defined is not defined. Epsilon closure of Q2 is Q2. Epsilon closure of not defined is not defined. And then output will be this, the union of these three. So output will be Q2. Now, if you have to again find epsilon or transition Q0 on one, what will you do? You will first find epsilon closure of Q0. What is epsilon closure of Q0? Q0, Q1, Q2. Then find what will happen on one. On Q0, if one comes, output will be Q0. On Q1, if one comes, output is not defined. Okay. On Q4, if one comes, output will be Q5. So then we have to find epsilon closure of these as well. So what is the epsilon closure of Q0? Epsilon closure of Q0 is Q0, Q1, Q4. Okay. Epsilon closure of not defined is not defined. Epsilon closure of Q5 is Q5. So it will be the union of these three. Okay. What is the union of these three? The union is Q0, Q1, Q4, Q5. So that means transition on Q0 on one output will be, we may be in this state, or this state. Okay. So you have to keep this in mind. So what you have to keep in mind? So let me make some space here. So we have to keep in mind that whenever we are discussing about a transition in epsilon NFA for any symbol. So what you have to do first, transition in epsilon NFA for state S on symbol A. So you have to do two things. What are the two things? The first is, first find epsilon closure of S, then second find possible transitions because of A in epsilon closure S. Okay, let's suppose possible transitions lead to these states S dash. Then third is find epsilon closure of all states in S dash. Let's suppose that epsilon closure is S double dash, and this S double dash will be the transition on state S because of symbol. So you have to find epsilon closures two times. Okay, so you should try out these two here, these two strings, and then find out whether you are able to answer whether these strings belong, whether these strings are accepted by this particular automata or not. Fine. Now let's see, can we make a transition table for this particular epsilon NFA. Let's make a transition table here. So the symbol can be 0 and 1. Okay. Let's see initial state. What will be the initial state here? Okay. So initial state is, so let's do one thing before discussing about the epsilon NFA. Let's first discuss about the NFA, then we can discuss about the epsilon NFA. Okay. So let me rub this and let's first discuss about the NFA. Let's make a transition table for NFA. Okay. So let me rub this. So let's see this particular NFA. This is an NFA, and if you can see, the language of this NFA is W, belongs to 0,1 star, such that W ends with 0,1 or 1. You can check it out. This is the language of this particular finite automata NFA. This is an NFA, not an epsilon NFA. Let's make a transition table for this. So I have already said that in a transition table, we have input from this side and we have states from this side. And while checking the states, the first state will be an initial state. Okay. Here initial state is Q0. Fine. So initial state is Q0. So let me write, this is initial state. So, and you have to remember, since the output of a transition function in NFAs is a set of states, so that is why we represent every state in this particular set notation in case of an NFA. Now on Q0, if 0 comes, what is the output? So on Q0, if 0 comes, what is the output? The output is, we may either be in Q0 or in Q1. So this is the output. So these two choices, Q0, Q1. So that means on 0, there are two choices. We may be in Q0 or we may be in Q1. Okay. Now if 1 comes, on Q0, if 1 comes, again, we have two choices. We will remain in Q0 or we will go to Q3. So we will remain in Q0 or we will go to Q3. Fine. So first row has been completed, this row. Now we have to check for the next state. What will be the next state? I have already discussed that whenever you have to design the next state, you have to check for which state we have not created a row. For Q0, we have created. For this particular Q0, Q1, we don't have any row. And this is a new state. So let's make another row for Q0, Q1. Okay. And this is also a new one, this Q0, Q3. So let's make another one for Q0, Q3. So these are our new states here. Fine. So let's first check for Q0, Q1. What will happen? So we have to check for Q0, Q1. Now on Q0, Q1, we have to check for zero, first for zero. So we will check for Q0 and we will check for Q1. Now for Q0, if zero comes, what is the output? Q0 and Q1. These two. On Q1, if zero comes, what is the output? Not defined. So the total will be the union of these three. What is the union of these three? Q0, Q1. Okay. So on zero, what will be the output? Q0, Q1. Now if one comes, so on Q0, comma Q1, if one comes, what will be the output? So on Q0, if one comes, output is Q0, Q3. And on Q1, if one comes, output is Q2. Okay. So then we have the union of these three. What is the union of these three? Q0, Q2, Q3. Now the second row is complete. Now we have to go to the third row. Okay. Now third row is Q0, Q3. Now on Q0, Q3, if zero comes, what is the output? On Q0, output is Q0, Q1. On Q3, output is not defined. So the union of these three is Q0, comma Q1. Okay. Now on Q0, comma Q3, if one comes, what is the output? On Q0, if one comes, the output is Q0, Q3. And on Q3, if one comes, the output is Q2, the union of these three. Q0, Q2. Fine. So the third row is completed. Now, is there any other state? Yes, this one has not been done because this has been done Q0, Q1 here. This has been done. This one has not been done. Which one? Q0, Q2, comma Q3. Now on Q0. So let me write it here. So on Q0, Q2, comma Q3, if zero comes, what will be the output? The output on Q0, output will be Q0, Q1. On Q2, output is not defined. On Q3, output is not defined. So output will be Q0, comma Q1. Now on Q0, Q2, Q3, if one comes, input one, what will be the output? Q0, output will be Q0, Q3. Q2, output will be on Q2, if one comes, output is not defined. Q3, if one comes, output is Q2. So output will be Q0, comma Q2, comma Q3. So this has been completed. Is there any other state here that has not been done yet? No, all have been done. This has been done. This has been done. This one done. This one has a row. This one has a row. This one has a row. All are completed. And now which one is the final from these? So which one? This is the initial state. Which one is the final? We know a final state will be that state which has at least one state as final. You can see here, at least one state is final. One state means one choice leads to a final state. So that means this is a final. So for a final state, we have to put asterisk, or we can put asterisk here because this is a final state. Okay, this one. Now let's see. Let's name this particular state as S0, this one, this as S1, this as S2, and this as S3. So is there any other state? No. So this will be, this one will be S1, this one will be S2, this one will be S3. This one is Q0, Q1. What is this? This is S1, Q0, Q1. This is also S1, this is S1, this is S3, and this is S3. Now from this transition table, I can design a finite automata. So in that finite automata, initial state will be S0. So this is S0. And we have other states, S1, S2, and S3. This is S1, this is S2, this is S3. S3 is our final state. Okay. Now let's check. So this is our initial state. Now on S0, this S0. If zero comes, where we will get go S1. So if zero comes, we will go to S1. If one comes, we will go to S2. Okay, S0 is complete. Now S1. In S1, if zero comes, we will go to S1. So if zero comes, we will go to S1. Okay. And if one comes, we will go to S3. If one comes, we will go to S3. Fine. So S1 is completed. Now S2. In S2, if zero comes, we will go to S1. In S2, if one comes, we will go to S3. In S2, if one comes, we will go to S3. Now we have S3. In S3, if zero comes, we will go to S2. If zero comes, we will go to S2. And in S3, if one comes, we will remain in S3. Is there any other state? No. You can see the language of this finite automata is same as this finite automata. And how I have created this finite automata? I have created this particular finite automata from this transition table. And this transition table has been created from this particular NFA. You can see that this particular finite automata is a DFA. And this particular finite automata is an NFA. So I can convert an NFA into a DFA by using this particular approach. This particular approach is called power set construction, or we can say subset construction. So you can convert any NFA to a DFA. Okay. Any NFA can be converted to a DFA. Using which scheme? Power set construction. And what is a power set construction? In a power set construction, first from an NFA, we create a transition table. Okay. And from that transition table, we create a DFA. So this scheme of converting an NFA into a DFA is called a power set or subset construction. And you can see that we can convert any NFA to a DFA. Okay, so let me rub some portion from here so that I can make some more points here. So let me rub these things from here. And this particular transition table also I will remove from here. Okay, so what we did that we said that NFA can be converted to a DFA. And how we convert? There are two steps. First, create a transition table for NFA. And second, from transition table, create a DFA. So now we have some important conclusions from here. What are the important conclusions? First, we know that language accepted by a DFA. Language accepted by a DFA. That language is called regular language. And from here, we can conclude language accepted by an NFA. That will also be a regular language. Why? Because if I have an NFA, okay, and that means this NFA is accepting some language L1. Now I can convert this NFA to DFA, to an equivalent DFA. So that means the language of this DFA is also which language? L1. So since L1 is accepted by a DFA, so that means L1 is regular language. Okay. So whenever I am saying that I have a regular language, what does that mean? That means I can design a DFA for this language, or we can say there will be a DFA for this particular language, or we can also say that there will be an NFA for this particular language. So from this, we can conclude they have same power, which DFA and NFA have same power. Why they have same power? Because any NFA can be converted to an equivalent DFA by using a power set construction, or it is also called a subset construction. Okay, so I have shown you here how to convert an NFA into a DFA. Now let's see how we can convert epsilon NFA to a DFA. So the similar procedure, the same procedure, power set construction, only some minor changes, we can convert an epsilon NFA to a DFA. So that means these two also have the same power. Okay. What does that mean? That means any language accepted by an epsilon NFA, we can create a DFA for that particular language. So regular languages are those languages for which we have a DFA, NFA, and an epsilon NFA. So let's discuss how we can convert an epsilon NFA into a DFA. Then after that, I will conclude this particular video. Okay. So let me wrap this portion and let's see how we can convert an epsilon NFA into a DFA using a power set construction scheme. So let me wrap this portion first. So let's take an epsilon NFA, a simple epsilon NFA. Sorry, let me rub name of these states here. It's Q1 here, it is Q2 here, this is Q3, this is Q4, okay, and this is Q5. Let's say zero. So this is an epsilon NFA. Now let's say I want to design a DFA for this particular, epsilon NFA. So let's first design a transition table. How we are going to design a transition table? We will have zero and one here. Fine. Now initial state, what is the initial state here? Q0. But you can see that from this initial state, we can go to Q1. So from this initial state, we can go to Q1 without consuming anything. And we can also go to Q4 without consuming anything.
And we can go to Q5 as well without consuming anything. Consuming anything means we can take two epsilon transitions, one and two. So that means from Q0, if we can say the epsilon closure of Q0, what will be the epsilon closure of Q0? It will be Q0, Q2, sorry, Q1, Q4, and Q5. Okay, this is the epsilon closure of Q0. So initial state won't be only Q0. It will be epsilon closure of Q0. Okay, and what is the epsilon closure of Q0? Q0, Q1, Q4, Q5. So this is the difference between an NFA. So when we were converting an NFA into a DFA, we were saying that initial state will remain same. But in case of an epsilon NFA, initial state will be the epsilon closure of the initial state. Okay. So what will be the initial state in the transition table here? The initial state will be the epsilon closure. And what is the epsilon closure? Q0, Q1, Q4, Q5. Okay, now on this initial state, on Q0, Q1, Q4, Q5, we have to check if 0 comes, what will be the output. So if 0 comes, first we have to check for Q0. If 0 comes, is there any transition defined? No, not defined. So if Q1, if 0 comes, is there transition defined? Not defined. On Q4, if 0 comes, which state comes? 0. Okay, 0 means that there is no transition defined, not defined on 0. On Q5, if 0 comes, what will be the output? The output will be Q3. Then after that, I have to find the epsilon closure of these. What is the epsilon closure of not defined? Not defined. Epsilon closure of not defined? Not defined. Epsilon closure of not defined? Not defined. Epsilon closure of Q3 will be Q3. So what will be the union of these? Union of these will be Q3. So if 0 comes, I will go to Q3. Now if 1 comes, so on the same state, this state, if 1 comes, okay, now 1 comes, on Q0, if 1 comes, what will be the output? Not defined. On Q1, if 1 comes, what will be the output? Q2. Okay. On Q4, if 1 comes, what will be the output? Not defined. On Q5, if 1 comes, what is the output? Not defined. Now we have to find epsilon closure of these. Epsilon closure of not defined and not defined. Epsilon closure of Q2 is Q2, Q3. You can see here, Q2, Q3. Epsilon closure of not defined is not defined. This is not defined. So what will be the output? The output will be Q2, Q3. Okay. The first row is completed. So this is completed. Now we have these two as new. This one and this one. These are new. So let's make one row for Q3 and another row for Q2, Q3. Let's first see Q3. On Q3, if 0 comes, okay, on Q3, if 0 comes, what is the output? Not defined. Okay, so that means output will be not defined. Not defined means pi. Pi means nothing, empty. So since here every state is a subset, you can see it is a subset. Subset of these states, NFA states. Okay. So pi means no state, not defined. So this is also one of the subset. Okay. Now on Q3, if 1 comes, again the output will be 5. So output will be 5. On Q2, Q3. So on Q2, Q3, if 0 comes, what will be the output? So on Q2, if 0 comes, output is not defined. On Q3, if 0 comes, output is not defined. Then epsilon closure of these will be not defined. So output will be not defined. Not defined means pi. Or we can say nothing. Now on Q2, Q3, if 1 comes. On Q2,
and Q3, if one comes, you will again check the output will be not defined. Not defined means 5. So this is done. This is done. Now we have 5. 5 is a new state. Okay. And there is nothing 5 here. So on 5, output will be 5 and 5. On 0, output will be not defined. On 1, output will be not defined. Is there any new state? No, there is no other state. Okay. So now let's name these states. Let's name this as S0. This will be our initial state. First check, what will be the final state? The final state will be the states or subsets that contain Q3. This one contains Q3, so this will be a final state. This one also contains Q3. This one will also be a final state. So let's name it S0. This is S1 and this is S2. This is S1, this is S2. And this one, let's name it S3. So this is S3, this is S3, this is S3, this is S3. This one is S3 and this one is S3. So how many states are there? 4 states. S0. S1, S2, and S3. And which one is the final state? S2 is the final state. Okay. So now let's make the transitions. So on S0, if 0 comes, we will go to S1. And you can see that S1 and S2 are our final states. On 0 comes, we will go to S1. If 1 comes, we will go to S2. On S1, if 0 comes, we will go to S3, 5 state. Or if 1 comes, we will go to S3. Okay. S2, if 0 comes, we will go to S3. And if 1 comes, we will go to S3. On S3, if 0 comes or 1 comes, we will remain in. So this is our DFA for this particular NFA, epsilon NFA. And this is how we convert an epsilon NFA to a DFA by using a power set construction scheme. Okay. And you can see that the states of this DFA, states of a DFA are subsets of states of NFA. Okay. So this was our NFA and its states were Q0, Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4, and Q5. You can see here the states of this particular DFA are the subsets of these states. So let's say there are N states. So how many subsets are possible? 2 raised power n. So that means maximum states in its DFA can be 2 raised power n. Maximum can be 2 raised power n, but it is almost every time less than 2 raised power n. So the number of states in NFA, in DFA is very large as compared to number of states in its equivalent NFA or epsilon NFA. And from this discussion, we also got some points. So one point is NFA, DFA, and epsilon NFA. They all have same power. So first is that they have same power. That means the language recognized by NFA will be recognized by DFA and will be recognized by NFA. And the languages accepted by these three are called regular languages. Okay. So for every regular language, there exists a DFA, there exists an NFA, and there exists an epsilon NFA. Okay. So this was all about the epsilon NFA, NFAs, and power, or we can say power set construction or subset construction, means converting an NFA or epsilon NFA into a DFA. Now let me give you some of the questions here that you should try to convert those NFAs and epsilon NFAs into DFAs. So let me wrap this portion and give you some of the homework. So let me write some of the problems here. First is, so this is one of the NFA. Q0,
Q1, Q2, and Q3. This is epsilon. This is A comma B. This is B comma C. And this is C comma A. Okay. And the alphabet set for this particular NFA, epsilon NFA, is ABC. So convert this epsilon NFA into a DFA and also find the language of this NFA. Okay. What will be the language accepted by this NFA? The second is this particular Q0. Then I have Q2. This is our final state. Then Q1. Here I have Q3. Q4. Okay. So this is another NFA, epsilon NFA. Convert this into DFA. So for both these, convert into DFA and find the language. Okay. So this is your homework that you should try to convert these NFAs into DFAs. So this was all about the non-deterministic finite automata's epsilon NFA and power set construction or subset construction. And from this, we concluded that all these NFA, DFA, and epsilon NFA, they have same power, and the language accepted by these or the language that they can recognize are called regular languages. Okay. So that means for every regular language, there exists a DFA. Okay. So with this, I will conclude this particular video or particular lecture, that is lecture number 11. However, in our next lecture, that is lecture number 12, we will discuss some of the properties of regular languages. Okay. And in that particular lecture, we will conclude all those properties that are associated with regular languages, and we will see how we can generate new regular languages from already, if we already have some regular languages, how we can generate new regular languages from those particular languages. So let's meet in the next lecture. Till then, goodbye.